I'm Charlie Francis, IFBB Pro. Today we're going to be doing shoulders and biceps and triceps. The way I train is very specific. So everything we do is under tension. So we're doing little movements, but at the same time, you'll feel something completely different to what you're used to doing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to pre-exhaust my front delts and my traps. We pre-exhaust the front delts and the traps, so when we're going to be doing a lateral movement, it's going to be just the side of the delta that's going to be working. I'm going to have my hands facing each other, and then I raise up and I just twist at the top, so you're really going to start focusing that front delt. And then the weight plate for the upright row is holding the plate just a little further out than normal. We're going to raise it up, and that's going to encourage the traps to engage a lot more. For the main part now, we're going to be doing a giant set. So we've got a lateral raise, which is going to be slightly, quite heavy, but once again, it is going to be concentrated. So the whole point of this movement is a very small, isolated movement. When you get your lats out, you're going to keep your arms nice and straight. And then it's a very small movement, and that's what's going to be working, the lateral side of the shoulder. We want as much focus on that lateral side of the shoulder as possible. Then we go into a front raise. Hold the dumbbell out in front, and then it's a very small pulse once again. This one here, creating as much tension on the shoulder as possible. Then that's what's going to allow it to grow, and it's going to allow it to shape up. Then we go into traps, and we're going to be doing shrugs. I know we've done that in pre-exhaust, but now we've tired them out, we've fatigued them. It's going to be a little bit more effective. So I like to lean my body forward slightly. I pull my shoulder blades back, and all I'm doing is just raising up. That's just going to encourage the traps to engage that a little bit more, just to work the movement better. Then we're going to be going into the upright row using a weight plate as well. Instead of when you see some guys in the gym, they're using as much of their body as possible. They encourage their back to get involved, their traps. They don't necessarily focus on their shoulders. So these movements, what we're going to be doing, it's going to be very, very effective. After all of the movements that we just done, doing a shoulder press right at the end of that little giant set, the shoulders are fatigued. The whole point of it is just to get as much of that blood into the shoulder, and then you're going to start to see that shape. So for arms, what I've done on the bicep, I only do one movement or two movements maximum. So we were doing drag curls today. So the whole point of this, keep as much tension on the bicep as possible without encouraging your shoulders to get involved, without encouraging your forearms to get involved. Obviously, we've just worked shoulders, so they're gonna be exhausted, so you've gotta try and take that away. The whole movement is you just pull your elbows back, you're squeezing at the top. As you can tell, this is your biceps going to be working as much as possible. So we want as much time under tension as possible. So the drag curl is one of the most effective movements you can do to build your biceps. So I like to do a double rope cable kickback. It's going to allow the tricep to lengthen fully. That squeeze at the top where you don't normally get just using a normal rope, that's what's going to be working the tricep a little bit more. just remember, you have to feel the muscle working instead of allowing other parts of your body to start engaging. Everything is all under tension. Very specific and detailed movements, but very effective. Thank you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave your comments below.